Good morning, everyone. It's Lee Henson, president, founder of AgileDad, and it's time for today's episode of the Daily Standup. Without any further ado, let's get started. Today, in keeping with our theme that we've had going here regarding backlog items, we talked about definition of ready, we talked about definition of done and why those were important. Today, I wanted to do a critical overview with Bill Wake's invest model. Now, I know many of you probably already say, okay, I'm familiar with invest, but you know, I want to make sure that you understand what each of the letters mean. And I want to make sure even more deeply that you understand how they apply, because I think that a lot of people understand what the letters are and they know it's an acronym and they go from there, but they don't necessarily know how to apply them to make sure that they're getting the most out of their backlog. So the I in invest stands for independent. Now, that means you should avoid dependencies when you can. Is it possible to avoid every dependency? Obviously not, right? But it is important for you when you see work that you can avoid a dependency that you take every opportunity to do so. The goal should be to not just, you know, try to work through dependencies or try to enhance dependencies. You know, you want to try to eliminate dependencies when at all possible. It's not always possible, but you should make your best valiant effort to do so. The N in invest stands for negotiable. Now, this is the interesting one. The way people used to always explain to me is that a story is not a placeholder for a contract. So if you have backlog items where you feel like you're contractually obligated to deliver something, you know, it should never feel like the team is having anything pushed upon them or forced upon them. So that N tells you, hey, that there's an opportunity for a conversation here and that we want you to be part of the conversation as well, that we're going to negotiate and we're going to talk things through to make sure that we have a good understanding of the product that's being asked for, the service that's being asked for, that we understand a backlog item and how it ties back to a clear, concise vision for what we're trying to do. And that leads me to the V. The V stands for valuable. Now, this is really interesting because what I can tell you is that a lot of the time we might feel like what we want to work on has incredible value. But when you survey the organization compared to other things that they could be doing with that time, what we're building has no intrinsic value. So it's important that we make sure we understand that, hey, you know, there are opportunities for us to have things that we believe or have perceived value, but we don't know what the true value is until that end consumer has the value in their hands, right? So far we said it needs to be independent, needs to be negotiable, needs to be valuable. Then there's the E, it's everyone's favorite. It's estimable or estimable, because estimatable is not a word, just saying. So this is the ability to estimate size or scope, right? It's the ability to follow through and really say, hey, I have my head around this work. And I think I can tell you now firsthand that most people don't have their head around the work when they say they do. So it's one of these things where you need to understand at a level where you can say, okay, based on this amount of work or based on this information, I think it's going to take, you know, I think this effort is, you know, a large effort or a medium effort, but I think you do have to have some kind of way to estimate. And this leads me to S. There have been battles for as long as I've been doing Scrum about whether or not we should size things using time or story points or both, and if there's any correlation or any kind of formula that goes back and forth. And what I can tell you is that S stands for sized appropriately. Now, if you listen to my definition of ready, one of my rules was that everything needs to be ready to be consumed in a sprint, that it needs to be consumable in a single sprint by a team member. And I think that's incredibly important here, because when we're talking about sized appropriately, I want to make sure that not only do we meet a basic definition or guideline for size, but that we have something that's going to be easily chomped up by the team and something that they could spit out the result that we're looking for. I think one of the biggest faults I find is when teams leave items too big, or they forget to break things down, or when they do, they do it fast because they're in a hurry, or whatever the case may be. I just think it's important for us to understand that size appropriately means that we took the time to make sure that it would fit within the boundaries of a single sprint and that the team is committed to delivering those things within the boundaries of the single sprint. And I think it's a two-way street, right? So I think there's a level of commitment there. So we have independent, negotiable, valuable, estimable, and sized appropriately. The last one is T. Now, T stands for testable. And this means that anything you build should be able to be tested. Now, I can tell you, a lot of times when you build things, it's harder to build things with that T in mind, knowing that it's going to have to be tested. But a lot of organizations are starting to turn to more test-driven design or automated testing precepts, so that what ends up happening is they have tested or set to fail before the code's ever written. So when somebody writes it, it's just going to be for a short term so that they can see whether or not the code is supposed to be behaving the way that it is. And they'll stop writing code as soon as all the tests pass. So I think it's important for us to understand that invest is a big time strategy. But I also want to point out, if any of you have ever invested before, like invested in the stock market or invested in, you know, a world-class training facility, whatever it might be, that it's important for you to know that there's risk. There's risk involved with investing, right? And the risk is that when you put your heart and soul into something, it may not always turn out exactly how you want. So I think it's important for you to assess that risk and understand that invest is a perfect model for people who, I don't want to say have it together, but invest is a perfect model for people who are trying to get their head around and understand what they need to do, but also in such a way that they're delivering high value frequently. And I think this ties back to ready again, yes? So these three topics that we cover for Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, they really do marry each other and they go well together hand in hand. I just encourage you, if you haven't read Bill Wake or William Wake's whole episode or his whole topic on invest, I encourage you to do that because there's lots of good meat and potatoes in there. There's lots of things that we can do to help move that message along. So as always, I hope that message was useful to you. I hope that you can visit agiledad.com and find more information about this topic and plenty of other topics that'll help you have success in your agile implementation. As always, we encourage you to stay healthy, stay well, and stay agile, my friends. Until next time, do take care.